Brisbane take a bow.
Absolutely relieved. This is the best news that we could have hoped for. Absolutely the best news.
No new community transmission cases, nearly 19,000 tests. The lockdown is lifted.
Thrilled in the fact that, you know, we've gotten over probably the worst of it, but we still have to be very, very vigilant.
And we'll need to breathe our collective sigh of relief into a mask.
So that we can get back to where we have been, which has been some of the lowest restrictions across the country.
Everyone in the hotspot zone needs to carry a mask for the next 10 days and must be worn anywhere indoors, shopping centres, supermarkets, public transport, gyms and workplaces where you can't socially distance. They don't need to be on while exercising outdoors or if you're travelling in your own car.
If you do feel compromised, if you feel that people aren't socially distancing, put your mask on. So when in doubt, wear a mask.
The masks are quite a game changer. We didn't have masks back in March when we did all of those restrictions then. We do have masks, so we can be more confident about our other strategies.
Although for some, the message hasn't quite gotten through. Some restrictions will be in place until 1 a.m. next Friday too. Venues are back to one person per 4 square metres or 1 in 2 if outdoors. You'll need to sit down while eating and drinking, and dancing is banned again.
A very small price to pay for safety.
Weddings are back to 100 people and everyone can dance there. Funerals also capped at 100 and up to 20 people can gather in homes or at the park. And after days of uncertainty, finally confirmation, the fourth test will go ahead at the Gabba. Fans will have to wear a mask as they enter and exit the stadium, but not at their seats. Capacity will be halved. 18,000 fans can attend each day.
We're really excited about welcoming both the Australian and Indian cricket teams and delivering a test match here next week at the Gabba.
We're a long way from being in the clear, but it's a big step in the right direction. John Paul Gonzo for 10 News First.